lo que importa es la libertad. La libertad de la gente y el bien de la humanidad.
Tomorrow is the start of hopefully a worldwide movement. And in Amsterdam, it's called Occupy Amsterdam. And people are gathering tomorrow at 12 o'clock. And actually the movement is really broad. It's happening in, I think, 80 different countries and really a lot of different cities worldwide. And the message is that the financial system, the way we have it now, is only looking after the individual, like benefits for individuals and not for the whole population or groups of people. People got really selfish and greedy, and they're only thinking about their own lives and own money. And like the movement in America, I mean, they say it's a bit, we are the 99%. I mean, you've heard this thing a lot already, but I think it makes sense in a way that 1% of the people, they hold the monopoly of all the money, and most of the people, they don't profit from it and they don't see anything back. And I think it's also about putting money above people, and I think that should change. I mean, people, we are all human, and money shouldn't be the thing that we pursue.
And do you think it would be a historical moment tomorrow?
I hope so. Uh-huh. Yeah.
What do you expecting? What do you think?
Well, in Amsterdam, I'm really curious about what's going to happen. I think for sure that tomorrow there will be, almost 3,000, hopefully 4,000 people, hopefully more. But the place where the sort of manifestation or the Occupy movement is in front of the Beurs van Berlage, Beursplein, and that's the sort of one of the financial centers in Holland or in Amsterdam. And of course, in the weekend there will be nobody working there. So if it continues until next week, until Monday, and people start arriving at their work and seeing this movement, hopefully people will camp there and stay there, and hopefully worldwide that will happen also. I'm curious about how many people feel energized to do this, and
And why is it important for people to demonstrate in that day, especially? What do you think, everybody should come?
Well, I think what's most important is that to unite as people, and not to unite because of you're part of a political party or you're part of some movement, but just as people to show that that we're all united, and that we're not we won't let ourselves be divided by parties or by certain ideas. So I think that's an important message, and it makes. Hopefully it will make people also, I think also people are starting to wake up a bit and realize that there's something wrong with the way the world is made right now, and that the realization that a lot of people put this as the world that is best possible, but I think a lot of people disagree with that. There are so many different options and so many different things that would be better for our world and better for us as people. Yeah.
So, what would you like to achieve tomorrow? How you would like to see it, that it would develop?
Well, I hope that it will not just only be tomorrow, that people will come to demonstrate or to be there for a day and then all go home and continue their lives the way they were living it. I hope that that this will continue until something bigger. And hopefully people will realize also that that's the only way that we can achieve it, if we stick together, and if we don't let people divide us or people tell us that we're only individuals and that we should think about our own benefits. So I hope that will happen.
Mm-hmm. So tomorrow, when?
Okay.
What to take?
Well, it's at 12 o'clock at Beursplein, which is in front of the Beurs van Berlage in Amsterdam, And yeah, I think the program, I'm not sure if there's an actual program. I think a lot of people have different ideas what they want to do. But it starts at 12 o'clock, so be there.